Hey friends, welcome to Creative X. My name is Brad Hussey, a web designer. I just recently started playing this game called Elden Ring on the Xbox. Perhaps you've heard of it. Anyway, I'm really quite enjoying it, but one of my favorite parts actually is the art, the creative work that you get to immerse yourself in, play with, and explore. It's very, very cool and quite beautiful, though a little gloomy and doomy. It makes me think of maybe a darker version of Zelda Breath of the Wild on the Nintendo Switch, which, by the way, I'm very excited about Tears of the Kingdom to come out, but let's leave that for another conversation. My point here is the art is very beautiful, and I thought, why not combine my interests in, say, this open world, beautiful art gameplay, specifically the Elden Ring style, with AI art and building websites in EditorX. So that's exactly what we're gonna do in this video. Let's do it. So the first thing I'd like to do is create a really beautiful scene that reminds me of that, you know, European medieval Elden Ring style, doomy gloomy scene with mountains and a range and a hero and some tarnished, you know, outfit. And that's kind of what I want to go for. All right, so I'm going to use the Midjourney prompt, imagine, to imagine a multi-layer nature scene, Elden Ring, fantasy art style, European mythology, darkness or depression, hero standing in the foreground, mountains in the background, and now this is what I get right here. Now this is very cool, and out of these options, I'm kind of liking this second one here. So I want to run with that. So what I'm gonna do in Midjourney, and this is in Discord, remember, is I'm gonna click V2, the little buttons that show up in under all of the options, and that will give me four variations of the second option. You can see it's the same scene, just different variations. So what I wanna do is use this third one right here, and I'm going to upscale that. Now, upscaling it means we're going to take this lo-fi rendering with a smaller, you know, pixel dimensions, and upscale it to something bigger so that we can use this in a large format and it would still maintain sharpness. And here's what I get right here. Very cool. So I'm gonna go ahead and beta upscale redo that. So that basically, from what I understand, is just upscales and redoes the image, upscales it, gives it more definition, gives it more detail, and makes it more of like a final format. And so then here we have it right here, which you can see there's more detail in the mountains, like there's more texture, there's more depth, and even in the foreground and in the cloak of the hero, there's more detail on the armor and whatnot. So very cool. So this is what I'm gonna do. So I'm gonna open this in the browser and download the image. And it's just a flat image. There are no layers, meaning they're not separated. It's all in one flat bitmap graphic. So what I wanna do is move this on over to Photoshop and separate the layers. And I'm gonna have to do a little bit of work here with Photoshop's AI content awareness tool, which basically creates and paints in something that's not there. Now, as we can see here, we've got our flat graphic. We need to separate this into layers. The first thing that I notice is the top of this mountain doesn't have the tip of it, and that kind of bugs me, and I couldn't quite figure out how to do that in Midjourney without totally changing up the rendering. I like this one, so I just thought, let's throw this in the Photoshop, and we're gonna work a little magic here and give the top of this mountain a summit. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna resize the canvas, crop that up, so now I've got a larger canvas with a blank space. I'm going to use the marquee tool to select that whole area and use the content aware fill feature, which is kind of like the, I don't know if it's AI or whatever it is that they're doing, but basically it will paint in what it assumes should be there. So let's see what it does on first pass. Not very good. So it's kind of, you know, it's not what I'm looking for. What I really want is that summit. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna try again. So I'm actually gonna select a larger space now and see if it understands maybe more context. It can see that there's a mountain kind of reaching the summit. So maybe I need to give it more information to work with. So I'm gonna also content aware this, and that's better. It's a little messy around the edges here and it doesn't quite work at the top. So what I'm gonna do is actually gonna leave it as is, and I'm gonna start using Content Aware again with what it's generated. So I'm gonna select this general area of the mountain, and I'm gonna Content Aware fill that, and that looks much better. Now this part at the top right of the image, obviously that's weird. What I need to be here is just sky. So let's see if we can fill that in with Content Aware. That's much better. It's kind of continued the mountains a bit, and some of them seem to be appearing off into the background. We'll work with that. We'll see if we can fix it in a moment. There's birds kind of up here in the top left. I don't really like that, so I'm gonna Content Aware that as well by using the lasso tool and just kind of custom choosing the area, and let's see what happens. A little bit better, but as we can see, we've got some stray random mess happening here, but usually you can fix that by selecting that area, Content Aware again, and boom, that looks absolutely perfect. After a few tries here, it's, you know what, it's fine. It's totally fine. So now what I need to do is I need to create separate layers, and this is where it's gonna get really cool. So what I wanna do is start out by selecting this hero. Photoshop does a good job of selecting objects. As you can see here, it's kind of already selected it perfectly. I'm gonna go ahead and open up the select and mask option where I can go ahead and be more specific and choose and paint in exactly what I want included in my selection. Okay, so here we have the hero cropped out. It looks great. All right, so now we're gonna move on to the mountain range. I'm going to roughly select around this hero in the mountain range layer using the lasso tool and use Content Aware fill to see what happens. It did a pretty good job at first pass. It's guessing at what should be in the middle here, and it's not quite exactly what it is that I want. So I'm just gonna go around a few times and see if we can get something better in the middle. And after a few passes here, I am satisfied. So now I'm gonna go ahead and select the foreground. So I'm gonna use the object selection tool in Photoshop to roughly select the area. And then I'm gonna open up, because it's a bit of a vague area to select, there's not a lot of contrast between the layers here, between the parts of the image. So I'm gonna select and mask. This does a much better job of fine-tuning my selection. So this is perfect right here. It's feathered nicely, perfect. So now I'm gonna take that and I'm going to delete the rest of the image. So now I need this second layer. So we have the foreground with the hero and the cliff, and we have the middle part, which is that mountain range that we see in the middle, and then we have the mountain in the background. So this mountain range, once I remove the foreground, we need to be able to have it continue on. We need to have something to fill in the rest of the image. So using the Content Aware fill for that general area, now we have what looks to be the rest of that foreground. So this, not foreground rather, the middle ground, perfect. Now what I need to do is separate this middle part of the mountain range with the mountains on the side with the background. And the background, there's gonna be a lot not there in this image, as you will see once I remove it. So this is what we need to fill in. All this transparent checkered area, we need to make that have something. And there's not a lot to work with here. So let's see how well the Content Aware tool does. So I'm roughly selecting that area with the lasso tool, Content Aware fill. As you can see, it's pretty messy. So let's try this again, fill in the rest of the areas and just kind of go bit by bit selecting areas. Gonna clean up certain areas with Content Aware and we're left with this. And I actually think that this is perfect. It almost looks like the mountains are emerging from clouds. And that's kind of what we want. We want it to be separate and to have its own layer and to be otherworldly. All right, so it's time to build this site out in EditorX. My idea here is to create separate layers and they all kind of move independently as you scroll, maybe they animate in. Heck, let's just figure out what we can do with what we have available in EditorX to create a really cool visual website experience. Now, you could just go to your browser's URL bar and type in editorx.new. And that will spin up a new EditorX site. But I've taken it one step further, and I have my handy dandy Stream Deck here, which lets me automate lots of things. And one of the things I've automated is my ability to just press this button right here, and it will spin up a new EditorX site for me right here in my browser. And what I'm gonna do is start out by uploading, that's the word, into my media manager, the site files. So I've gone ahead and done that here. So I've got my mountain range right here. I've got my mountain background right here. And I've got my hero in the foreground right here. So what I'm gonna do is start out by choosing this section right here, and I'm gonna give it a background. And that background is gonna be my, well, mountain background. So I'm gonna change that background, and we're off to a good start. I mean, this doesn't look at all what it is that I want, but it's easily fixed by just changing the layout. Perfect. So here we have our mountain background. What I'm gonna do now is, in my layers, you can see I've got my section. I'm gonna quick add or drag in another element here, and that's gonna be an image. So here's my image, and I'm gonna change this image to be my mountain range, that mid ground, if you will. I'm gonna upload that into here. Then what I'll do is I'll make the width 100%. Okay. So now what I want to do is make sure that this image is docked to the bottom. And then I also want to change the focal point of this to go a little bit higher, not the center. I want to be able to see the tips of the mountains here as well. Also, so it doesn't cut off within the website. So here we go. We've got our focal point set. And then I'm going to add another image in here. And that's going to be our foreground. And then what I'll do with this is make sure the width is 100%. And I'm gonna make sure that it is docked to the bottom at zero margin. Okay, so right now we just simply have a scene that's very static in nature. I might as well have just uploaded the image and scaled it to fill the screen. I want each of these layers to move independently to give us this really cool parallax style illusion. I mean, we went through all this work to separate the layers. Let's like flex a little, am I right? So let's go back to editing our site, and I'm gonna start out by selecting this background, and I'm going to choose background scroll effects, and I'm gonna choose close up. Now our image, I actually want to, if I'm envisioning this right, I want the image of the hero on the foreground to stay fixed, almost like you're looking from the perspective of the hero. And everything else is kind of moving from that perspective. And so the hero is gonna stay pinned. The position type will be pinned to the page, and it will be docked from the bottom at zero. So we see the whole foreground. Okay, you can kind of see it a little bit there. You don't see the animations and the effects in edit mode in Editor X. You have to preview it first or publish the site in order to see all of the effects. All right, so now I've selected our hero. I'm gonna make our hero glide in as well, and we're gonna be a little more subtle here. So we're gonna go 180 degrees coming from the bottom, and we want the distance to be pretty far. So the maximum is 300 pixels in our animation settings, and the duration, let's have this fade in maybe 3 seconds. Now you can see in our layers that our hero is pinned, because that means that the hero is pinned to the page in this case and will always remain in view no matter where you scroll. And that's what we want here for the effect. The mountains in the background are basically very large 200 viewport height. So there's a lot of scroll room and it fills out that amount. So there's a lot to scroll here. And then we're animating and we have a scroll effect, which is gonna be our close up effect. And then we have the valley in the middle, which is going to animate in. So if we've done this correctly, when I hit preview, you should be taken on an epic mythological journey of mystery and wonder, all using AI art, little Photoshop magic, and Editor X. So before we show you that, make sure you like this video, subscribe to the channel, and I invite you to join us in the Creative X crew. That's my community of creative professionals, freelancers, and web agency owners. We meet twice a week, office hours, we do events, we do networking, lots of really cool stuff, lots of training in there to help you grow your business, to get better at Editor X, and to help you succeed. So the link is down below. Without further ado, let's check it out.